Hello everybody, it's Josie here. I'm going to be doing a mini book haul today. So one of my goals for the end of October was to read all of my books on my TBR so that I could literally go into November with a clean slate. I can focus on my rereading, which is something that I've been wanting to do for pretty much all year and haven't gotten around to reading anything new because I've been trying to clear my TBR. So obviously, I'm trying not to put too many new books on my TBR. Having said that, I am an avid reader. I'm on this channel. I love books. I love reading. And I literally cannot just not buy anything. And particularly when I watch other YouTubers' videos, I'm always like, oh, that sounds really cool. I want to read that. Or, you know, I want to get something because I've read the first book. Or I want to read everything the author's read. So, written. So I have been adding, but I think for me this is quite a restrained pile, and I will definitely get through all of these books by the end of October, 100%. So these are the books that I've got. So the first one is this book over here. This is called The Falconer by Dana Kapnick? Sorry, I murdered that. I should have looked that up beforehand. But this sounds really interesting. So also, as you know, I'm planning only to read queer books. I think this is queer content. I'm not 100% sure, but I think by the blurb. So on the back it says, love basketball, ball, art, music, friendship, feminism, and dreams. And it sounds incredible. So it's about an athlete. Her name is Lucy Adler. And she's kind of on the cusp of womanhood. So I believe this is set at university, which I really, really love. And it's kind of her coming to terms with who she is, what she wants to be, that kind of coming of age story I really love. And I feel like we have far too few university style and sort of, not YA, but just kind of on that cusp of womanhood, as they say in here, books. And I love that kind of thing. So I think this sounds really good. It just sounds like it's my, just from that alone, I kind of bought it. I was like, that sounds like it's my kind of book. I'm expecting good things from it. I will let you know what I think. Then the next one is this book over here. It's The Accidents Season by Moira Firely Doyle. What is wrong with me today? I'm so sorry, I can't talk. So this book, you can see, so The Falconer was new. This book is secondhand. And I have been wanting to read this because I'm trying to complete all of Moira Fowley Doyle's books. I've read The Spellbook of the Lost and Found. I just recently read All the Bad Apples, which is the latest release. I read a really great short story in an anthology, which I will talk about. And then I want to read this one. So I can kind of talk about all of her books. So this kind of completes my kind of arc of Moira books. And I really want some more because at the moment I'm loving them. So I'm kind of hoping that The Accident Season is going to be another one that I love. It sounds really good. So it says, it's the accident season, the same time every year. Bones break, skin tears, bruises bloom. And I believe it's about a 17-year-old girl and sort of these accidents keep happening to members of her family. And I think if I know Moira's books, it's kind of a little bit magical realism in it. I'm told that there's queer characters in this as well. So again, I will obviously let you know about that. Then the next book is one I've actually already read. I was so excited to get this. So it is To Be Taught If Fortunate by Becky Chambers. I was also lucky enough, Waterstones had a signed copy. So I got a signed copy. If you've heard me rant, and I've got a video that literally says I love Becky Chambers. I love Becky Chambers. I love their series, The Long Way to a Small Angry Planet. That all three of those books are amazing. Becky Chambers can write sci-fi so brilliantly and with so much heart, and they've really kind of made me discover a new love of sci-fi. Like I'm totally picking up so many more sci-fi books because of Becky Chambers, but I also know now what I like within the sci-fi genre, which is really much more character-based, much more heart-based books rather than, I suppose, kind of fighting and you know, kind of space wars and things like that. So Becky Chambers has really kind of helped me redefine what I like. I can't say, this is very short, this is a novella. And it's basically about a group of scientists, and they're human, and they go to different planets to sort of just study the planets. yeah, there's not much else I want to say because you've kind of got to read it, and it is very character focused. And what I love about this is, again, you've got a very diverse cast. So you've got queer transgender rep, and also you have disability rep within. And the story is not about that, but just the way the characters are framed and who they are, and when Becky tells you about them, that, you know, you've got that rep, which I really love. And again, it's just a hallmark of their books as well. Then the next one is Salt Slow by Julia Armfield. Gorgeous cover. This is going to be actually in another video I'm doing, which is a follow-up to my favorite, you know, most beautiful covers. And this is actually going to be featured in there. It's just so pretty. So this is a anthology collection of short stories. Again, I believe there is queer content, so queer characters in these, quite feminist, quite sort of contemporary, slightly eerie, slightly dark, just the kind of thing I like, hopefully. So I have high hopes for this. It's a beautiful book, and I'm hoping that the stories will live up to it. This will also be featured in another video that I'm doing, which I'm going to be talking about a lot of the anthologies and short story collections that I've been reading recently. So I've read quite a few of those. I've got a pile over there with them. And this, once I finish reading this, which I'm going to do very soon, this is going to go in that video as well. Then the second last one is this one over here. It's Tunnel of Bones by Victoria Schwab. First of all, another cool cover. Get a load of that. I love that. So you've got like your skeletons, which are the catacombs, I'm assuming. And then you've got like the Eiffel Tower. So this is a follow up to City of Ghosts by Victoria Schwab, which I read last year. I think I read it for Spookathon, actually. But I loved that book. It is, I say it's YA, I would say it's more younger YA, that the character herself is YA, but then the actual book did have some really quite dark, spooky themes in it, so I really enjoyed it, and that one was set in Edinburgh. So the premise of these books is that you've got the main character, Cass, I think, yeah. Cass, whose parents are, so her father is a kind of a historian, and her mother is into the supernatural, and their parents do like a ghost hunters style show. So her parents are quite successful writing books, and they get offered to do sort of a ghost hunters style show where they go all around the world to kind of the most haunted cities in the world. And they kind of go around, they talk about the hot spots and all of that. And then the first one was set in Edinburgh. Obviously, I won't tell you what happened if you want to read that. And then this is the follow-up. So this time they go to Paris, which just holds special love for me because I adore Paris. Catacombs are something that I haven't been able to see, and I'm going to one day see them. And yeah, I just think it's going to be most things set in Paris. This is one of my things that if something's set in Paris, I tend to want to read it. So not only did I enjoy the first book, and actually, having said that, I wanted to, because I'd unhauled the book, but I actually wanted to sort of reread it in anticipation for this, and I had the audiobook for it for my library. They had it on audiobook, and I love the audiobook. I feel like I almost like the audiobook a little bit more than the physical reading. I don't know why. Maybe I was just in a frame of mind for it. I don't know, but I really enjoyed the audiobook. So that's really kind of made me very excited to pick up Tunnel of Bones. Yeah, I think it's going to be good. This is going to be on my, one of the books I'm going to be using for, obviously, October, probably Spookathon. And then the next book, or the last book that I've got, is another glorious cover, in my opinion, is Labyrinth Lost by Zoraida Cordova. This is one that's kind of been on my list of books to read forever. Everybody that's read it says it's really good. It's about brujas, witches. You know, there's obviously witchy, fantastical elements in it. There's also queer characters in it, I've been told. So I've got high hopes for this book because everybody that's read it and reviewed it has said that they loved it. And I wanted to get, I mean, I was lucky enough on, this is actually secondhand, but it's, I don't think it's actually been read. It's gorgeous. And this is the gorgeous hardcover. And I was going to show you underneath, the camera can pick that up. That is so cool. Look at the candy skull. Anyway, besides the fact that it looks beautiful, I'm expecting it to be beautiful. And this is going to be another one of my Halloween Spookathon reads. And that's it. Those are all the books. Let me know if you've read any of these and what you thought of them. And I will speak to you all again very soon. Bye-bye.